can take rest, cause the living God is living in my chest. Every day I wake up feeling blessed.
Yeah,
holy is the Lord.
Yeah,
the whole earth is filled with his glory. Holy is the Lord. Hallelujah. We must believe that God is making an eternal deposit.
Så må vi virkelig tro på, at Gud han foretager sig noget internt i os.
You will never be the same.
Han lægger noget i os, du vil aldrig blive den samme igen.
Just like the Lord's disciples,
ligesom Herrens disciple,
who in obedience gathered in an upper room,
som i lydighed samlede sig i det øvre rum.
And I'm sure they sang songs like we did tonight.
Jeg tror på, at de samme sange, som vi gør i aften.
Because Jesus said, go and wait.
For Jesus sagde, go og vent.
We're waiting for you.
Vi venter på dig.
I'm sure they were singing something like that.
Jeg tror, de sang noget lignende det.
We're waiting for you.
Vi venter på dig.
Holy Spirit, walk in the room.
Helligånd, træd ind i lokalet.
Because when the presence of the Lord comes,
fordi når Herrens nærvær kommer,
everything changes.
Forvandles alt.
Everything changes.
Alt bliver forvandlet.
Every knee bows.
Et hvert knæ bøjer sig.
Before the presence of the Lord.
I Herrens nærvær.
We have read history.
Vi har læst historie.
Of what happened in that upper room.
Om hvad der skete.
And the church has advanced into every nation on the earth because of that one encounter. But my question is for you. What will you receive in the presence of the Lord tonight? What will you receive?
Hvad vil du modtage?
That in 1 year from tonight,
som om et år fra i aften,
that we can testify.
Som vi kan vidne om.
I was in a service last year.
Jeg var på et møde sidste år.
And the presence of the Lord was so thick.
Og Herrens nærvær var så tyk.
The glory of the Lord was so present.
Hans herlighed var manifesteret.
That God did such a work in me.
At Gud gjorde sådan et arbejde i mig.
He lit a fire in me.
Han tændte en ild i mig.
That continues to burn.
Som blev ved med at brænde.
And we hear of the testimonies.
Og vi hører vidnesbyrd.
Of how the kingdom of God has continued to advance.
Hvordan Guds rige er blevet ved med at have fremgang.
Because of meetings just like this.
På grund af møder som disse.
We came to receive.
Vi er kommet for at modtage.
And maybe you're asking, Brother Bill, how many times do we need to receive?
Og måske så spørger du, Bror Bill, hvor ofte skal vi modtage?
As much as it takes.
Lige så meget som det kræves.
Because sometimes I leak.
Fordi nogle gange så er jeg utæt.
Hello.
Hello.
I leak.
Samtidig så er jeg utæt.
And I need to be filled again.
Og så må jeg blive fyldt op igen.
Huh? Sometimes I'm tired.
Nogle gange er jeg træt.
But I need to be refreshed again.
Men jeg må blive fornyet igen.
Sometimes I'm confused.
Nogle gange er jeg forvirret.
And I need to be refreshed again.
Og så må jeg blive opfrisket igen.
I need the mind of the Lord again.
Jeg må blive mindet om ham igen.
I need the vision of God again.
Hans visioner fra Gud igen.
Seasons come and seasons go.
Tider kommer og tider de går.
But we always need times of refreshing.
Men vi har altid brug for tider af genopfriskning.
From the presence of the Lord.
Af hans nærvær.
It's raining in here.
Det regner herinde.
It's the rain of heaven in this
house. Det er himlens regn på det her sted.
It's times of refreshing.
Det er tider af genopfriskelse.
From the presence of the Lord.
Af hans nærvær.
You know, I took this cup of water.
Jeg tog den her kop med vand.
And I was reminded.
Og jeg blev mindet om.
That sometimes we look at the presence of God.
Så jeg kigger vi på Guds nærvær.
It's Lord, just give me a little bit.
Og vi er sådan, jamen Gud, bare giv mig lidt.
Just a quick drink.
Bare lige en hurtig en.
Yeah. But then we become thirsty.
Men så bliver vi tørstige.
And we need another drink.
Og så har vi brug for en mere.
Jesus said, come.
Jesus sagde, kom.
And drink.
Og drik.
Of the water of life freely.
Af livsvandet gratis.
Come, taste and see.
Kom, smag og se.
He said, come to the waters.
Han sagde, kom til vandet.
Come to the river.
Kom til floden.
Come and drink.
Kom og drik.
And be satisfied.
Og bliv tilfredsgjort.
But I think it takes more than a small cup.
Jeg tror, det kræver mere end bare en kop vand.
Because my Bible says,
min Bibel siger,
in John chapter 7,
i Johannes 7,
that from my belly,
at fra min mave,
will flow rivers of living water.
Vil der flyde floder af levende vand.
And Jesus was speaking about the Holy Spirit.
Og når Jesus talte om den hellige ånd.
If you want a river,
hvis du vil have en flod,
you need more than a cup.
Så har du brug for mere end en kop.
Hello.
Hallo.
Throw that cup away.
Smid koppen væk.
And get a water hose.
Og så få dig en vandslange.
Fill me.
Fyld mig.
Fill me to overflowing.
Fyld mig til overflod.
The Bible says that there is a river that flows from the throne of God.
Bibelen siger, at der er en flod, der render fra hans trone.
We need to be filled.
Vi skal fyldes op.
If we're going to release rivers,
hvis vi skal løsgive floder,
we need to be filled by rivers.
Så må vi blive fyldt af dem.
It's rivers in.
Det er floder ind.
And rivers out.
Og floder ud.
Hello. In the same measure.
Det samme mål.
That's what Jesus said. In the same measure,
som Jesus siger, med det samme
that
mål,
you give,
som du giver,
you receive.
Modtager du.
But let me say it also this way.
Men lad mig sige det sådan her.
In the same measure you receive,
med det samme mål du modtager,
is the same measure you release.
Er det samme mål du giver.
It's rivers in,
det er floder ind,
and rivers out,
og floder ud.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Fill us, O God.
Fyld os, Gud.
Halleluja. You know, when we speak about this cup,
når vi taler om den her kop,
some people just want to be exposed to the presence of God.
Nogle, de vil bare blive gerne være udsat for hans nærvær.
They want to be able to say, "Oh my, the presence of the Lord was wonderful tonight."
De vil gerne være i stand til at sige, "Jamen hans nærvær var bare godt i aften."
But when they walk out the door,
men i det de træder ud af døren,
they've only been exposed to the presence of God.
Så er de bare blevet udsat for den.
They have not been saturated.
De er ikke, de er ikke blevet gennemvædet. De er ikke blevet, ja, gennemblødt i det.
We need to be saturated by the presence of the Lord.
Vi skal gennemblødes i hans nærvær.
You cannot give what you have not received.
Du kan jo ikke give det, som du ikke har fået.
Hello.
Hallo.
And we carry the presence of the Lord with us.
Og vi bærer rundt på hans nærvær.
So we need to be saturated.
Så vi skal gennemvædes.
Another way to say this.
En anden måde at sige det på.
God doesn't want visitation rights.
Gud, han vil ikke bare gerne have besøgstider eller besøgsret.
He wants habitation.
Men han vil have en beboelse. Han vil have et bo.
The biblical principle is habitation.
Den bibelske princip, det er beboelse.
I'm moving into your house.
Jeg flytter ind i dit hus.
I'm invading your house.
Jeg invaderer dit hjem.
Move over.
Flyt dig.
Put a bed in your house for me.
Og så gør en seng klar til mig.
Brother Bill's moving in.
Brother Bill, han flytter ind.
Tell the family to scoot over.
Og fortæl familien lige at flytte sig.
God wants habitation.
Han vil have en beboelse.
Not visitation.
Ikke bare besøgstider.
And for habitation.
Og for at beboelse kan finde sted.
We need more than a cup.
Så skal vi have mere end en kop.
We need to be all in.
Så skal vi være helt i.
I'm going for it.
Det er det, jeg går efter.
I'm going for the presence of the Lord.
Jeg går efter hans nærvær.
I'm all in.
Jeg er helt i.
I'm not going to play around the edges.
Jeg skal ikke bare lege ved kanten.
See, that's what Ezekiel 47 is all about.
Det er det, Ezekiel 47 handler om.
That from the presence of the Lord.
At fra Herrens nærvær.
From the sanctuary.
Fra hans helligdom. Fra
there was a river that flowed to the east.
Der var der en flod, som løb imod øst.
And the prophet measured out.
Og profeten, han målte ud.
A certain distance.
Til et bestemt sted.
And he noticed that there was waters to the ankle.
Han trådte ud, så der var op til anklerne.
He was talking about the glory of God.
Han talte om Guds herlighed.
He was talking about the presence of the Lord.
Hans nærvær.
He said, and he measured again.
Og så målte han længere ud.
He said, and there was waters to the knees.
Og så var der vand til knæerne.
You see, even with the ankles and the knees, you are in control.
Selv ved anklerne og knæerne, så er du stadigvæk i kontrol.
You can control how much of the river you are exposed to.
Du kan kontrollere hvor meget floden du bliver udsat for.
But the prophet measured again.
Men profeten han målte længere ud.
Now it's to the waist.
Nu er det op til hofterne.
You're still in control.
Du er stadigvæk i kontrol.
But it's moving you.
Men nu bevæger det dig.
Huh? You feel the current of the river.
Du kan mærke strømmen.
And it's moving you.
Og det bevæger dig.
But you're still in control.
Men det er dig der er i kontrol stadigvæk.
You can still leave.
Du kan stadigvæk gå fra.
But he measured out one more time.
Men så måler han ud igen.
Would you join me tonight?
Vil du komme med mig?
In measuring out one more time.
Og så måler ud endnu en gang.
To rivers to swim in.
I floder hvor vi skal svømme.
Because in that place.
På det sted.
The Lord is in control.
Der er Herren i kontrol.
And we're all in.
Og vi er alle med.
And where the river takes us.
Og når floden tager os.
Is life.
Så er det liv.
And there are trees by that river.
Og der er træer ved floden.
There's fruit on those trees.
Og der er frugter på de træer.
And the Bible says in Ezekiel chapter 47.
Og i Ezekiel 47 står der.
That the leaves on those trees.
At bladene der.
Are for the healing of the nations.
Er for helbredelse af nationer.
What are you receiving tonight?
Hvad modtager du i aften?
What have you purposed in your heart?
Hvad har du i dit hjerte?
That you will receive from this conference.
Som du har modtaget herfra.
More than just good teaching.
Mere end bare god lærer.
And it has been wonderful.
Det har været fantastisk.
Praise the Lord for Brother Henrik.
Priset være Herren for
that
Henrik.
That guy is amazing teacher.
Den fyr er fantastisk.
I'm on line upon line.
Og jeg mener bare skrift efter skrift, linje efter linje.
I honor the gift in that man.
Og jeg ærer bare gaverne i den mand.
But we need more than teaching.
Men vi har brug for mere end lærer.
We need an eternal deposit.
Men vi har brug for noget, der er noget, der bliver lagt ind i os.
Of the truth of that word.
Sandheden af det ord.
With the spirit of the Lord.
Ved Helligåndens ånd.
That will drive it deep into our spirit.
Som bliver drevet dybt ind i vores ånd.
It become part of our belief system.
Det bliver en del af vores trosystem.
And that we walk differently.
Og vi vandrer anderledes.
We talk differently.
Vi taler anderledes.
Our relationships are different.
Vores fællesskab
because
er anderledes.
We have been eternally touched by the presence
fordi
of the
vi er
Lord.
Blevet berørt indeni.
We know the presence of the Lord.
Vi kender hans nærvær.
But would you measure out one more time?
Men vil du bare måle ud en gang mere?
I don't know where you are. Maybe your ankle or knee
or up to the waist. Knæerne, eller op til hofterne.
I don't know. But would you measure one more time?
Men vil du bare lige måle ud en gang
mere? Would you just step out a little bit deeper?
Kan du bare træde ud lidt dybere?
Oh! Step out a little bit deeper.
Bare ud lidt længere.
Into the river of God.
Ud i Guds flod.
Because it's life.
For det er liv.
It's joy.
Og det er glæde.
It's transformation.
Og det er transformation.
And we will never be the same.
Og vi bliver aldrig de samme.
If we will walk out deeper.
Hvis vi bare vil træde dybere ud.
We will receive vision from heaven.
Så får vi visioner fra himlen.
We will be empowered by the Holy Spirit.
Og vi får kraft ved den hellige ånd.
To take us further.
Til at tage os længere.
To give us the strength of God.
Til at give os Guds styrke.
To accomplish the will of God.
Og til at gøre hans vilje.
Let the river take you.
Lad floden tage dig.
During the Welsh revival. During the revival.
Yeah, vækkelsen i Wales.
And one of the leaders, his name was Evan Roberts.
Evan Roberts, han var en af lederne der.
And a newspaper reporter was asking him some questions.
Og der var en journalist der, som stillede ham spørgsmål.
Because they noticed that the revival was so amazing.
Fordi de opdagede jo, at væksten var fantastisk.
All of the drunks were saved and sitting on the front row of the church.
Alle alkoholikerne, de blev frelst, de sad på forreste række.
Many policemen had no job.
Og mange politimænd, de var nu uden job.
Because there was no crime.
Fordi der var ikke nogen kriminalitet.
They had been so touched by the presence of the Lord.
De var blevet berørt sådan af den hellige ånd.
And the reporter asked Evan this question.
Og journalisten spurgte Evan det her.
He said, "What are you going to do with this revival?"
Hvad vil du gøre med denne vækkelse?
And Evan said, "No, that is not the question."
Evan sagde, det er ikke spørgsmålet.
The question is.
Spørgsmålet er.
What is this revival going to do with me?
Hvad vil denne vækkelse gøre med mig?
What is it going to do with me?
Hvad vil den gøre med mig?
How is God going to be changing me?
Hvordan vil Gud forandre mig?
How will this presence of the Lord transform my life?
Hvordan vil denne Herrens nærvær forvandle mit liv?
Transform my marriage.
Transformere mit ægteskab.
My family.
Min familie.
The church that I pastor.
Kirken, hvor jeg er pastor.
The church where I'm a leader.
Hvor jeg er leder.
How will the presence of God impact me?
Hvordan vil hans nærvær have indflydelse på mig?
Where we can love people,
hvor vi kan elske mennesker,
in the way that God loves people,
på samme måde som Gud elsker
that
mennesker,
that we can represent the Lord,
at vi kan repræsentere Herren,
in the truest sense on the earth,
på den sande måde her på jorden.
It's not us doing something.
Det er ikke os som gør noget.
It's God doing us.
Det er Gud som gør noget i os.
I don't want control.
Jeg vil ikke have kontrol.
I make a mess of my life when I'm in control.
Jeg laver bare rod, når det er mig, der er i kontrol.
I mess up everything when I'm in control.
Jeg laver rod i det hele, når det er mig, der er i kontrol.
Because my wisdom is earthly.
Fordi min visdom, den er jordisk.
Sometimes our wisdom can be evil.
Samtidig så er vores visdom ond.
And not produce the correct results.
Og producerer ikke de rigtige resultater.
And we look back at those things.
Og vi ser tilbage på de
well,
ting.
Well, I thought that was the correct decision.
Og jeg troede, det var den rigtige beslutning.
But obviously it wasn't.
Men åbenbart ikke.
But the wisdom of God.
Men Guds visdom.
Is heavenly.
Er himmelsk.
It's perfect.
Den er perfekt.
We can receive downloads in the presence of God.
Vi kan bare få downloads.
Come on, pastors and leaders, church
pastor
leaders.
Pastor og leder.
Please hear what I'm saying.
Hør efter.
That while we're in the presence of the Lord tonight.
Hans nærvær her i aften.
God can download heavenly strategies.
Så kan Gud download, han kan give jer himmelske
strategier.
Strategier
for evangelism.
Strategier til evangelisere.
For outreach.
Og outreach.
How to love our cities.
Hvordan vi skal elske vores byer.
How to take the gospel to the nations.
Hvordan
to the
vi skal
earth.
Tage hans ord til verdens ende.
Let God put his vision on the inside of you.
Lad ham give dig sine visioner.
As we're in the presence of the Lord.
Når vi er i Guds nærvær.
Let him make an eternal deposit.
Så lad ham giv dig noget indeni.
If this is the case,
hvis det er tilfældet,
your church will never be the same.
Vil din kirke aldrig blive den samme igen.
You will never be the same.
Du vil aldrig blive den samme igen.
Your marriage will never be the same.
Dit ægteskab vil aldrig blive den samme igen.
So, put your hands up.
Løft dine hænder.
You're under arrest of the Holy Spirit.
Helligånden har dig under arrest. Den arresterer dig.
Yeah, like a gun in your back.
Har en pistol i ryggen på dig.
You're under arrest of the Holy Spirit.
Helligånden har anholdt dig.
That's what you do, right? When you're under arrest, you
det er jo det, du gør, når du er blevet anholdt.
Hallelujah. So Holy Spirit,
Helligånden,
we say you know everything.
Vi ved, at du ved alt.
Our knowledge is limited.
Vores viden er begrænset.
Our way is not perfect.
Vores vej er ikke perfekt.
But God, you are perfect in all your ways.
Men du er perfekt på alle områder.
So we press into the presence of the Lord.
Så vi presser os ind i dit nærvær.
We measure out deeper.
Vi tager et skridt længere ud.
We measure out deeper.
Vi tager et skridt længere ud.
into the presence of the Lord,
i Guds nærvær,
into the glory of the Lord,
ind i Guds herlighed,
that's being released in this building tonight,
som bliver udgydt lige nu på det her sted.
And we say, we are here for you to change us.
Og vi er her for at du kan ændre os.
We need to be transformed.
Vi har behov for at blive transformeret.
To the image of Jesus.
Til Guds billede.
We want the world to see Jesus in us.
Vi vil have, at verden skal se Jesus i os.
We want the world to see Jesus in the church.
Vi vil have, at verden ser Jesus i kirken.
But we cannot do church without you, O God.
Men vi kan ikke være kirke uden dig.
So Holy Spirit,
så Helligånd,
you are our partner.
Du er vores partner.
In ministry,
i tjeneste,
and in life,
i liv,
we say, invade us.
Invader os.
Invade this house.
Invader det her hus.
Invade my life.
Invader mit liv.
Invade us.
Invader os.
We ask you, Holy Spirit,
og vi siger dig bare, Helligånd,
as we press into the presence of the Lord,
vi presser os på,
we make a declaration.
Så laver vi en deklaration lige nu.
We will never be the same.
Vi vil aldrig blive de samme.
We will never be the same.
Vi vil aldrig blive de samme.
Would you say that with me?
Vil du sige det med mig?
I will never be the same.
Jeg vil aldrig være den samme.
That is my desire.
Det er min længsel.
I traveled all the way to Denmark.
Jeg er kommet hele vejen til Danmark.
Not because I didn't have something else to do.
Ikke fordi jeg ikke havde noget andet at lave.
There's plenty of things to do in other places.
Der er rigeligt at lave rundt omkring.
But there's an appointment with God in this house.
Men der er et møde med Gud her.
There's an encounter with God
der
in this house.
Der er et møde med ham lige her.
We're waiting for it right now.
Vi venter på ham.
We're ready for it.
Vi venter på.
Come on, are you ready for it?
Er du klar?
Are you ready for it?
Er du klar?
Because there's a river.
Der er en flod.
That is flooding this house.
Som oversvømmer deres sted.
As we begin to worship,
i det vi begynder at lovsynge ham,
press in,
og vi presser på.
Maybe you need to come forward.
Come again.
Maybe you need to come forward.
Måske har du behov for at komme frem.
Whatever you need to do,
hvad har du brug for at gøre?
To step into the presence of the Lord.
Du skal træde ind i hans nærvær.
Come on, let's step into the presence of the Lord.
Lad os træde ud i hans nærvær.
Fill the room.
Fyld det her lokale op.
Fill the room.
Fyld rummet op.
We make room for you, Holy Spirit.
Vi skaber plads til dig.
Fill this room.
Fyld det her rum op.
Fill this room.
Fyld det her rum op.
We're ready for you. Come on. Come on and drink.
Come and drink.
Drink from the river of life.
Drink from the river's flow.
Fill the room. We're ready for you. We're waiting for you. We're ready for you. We have an appointment.
Du har et møde med ham.
We have an appointment with
God. Vi har et møde med Gud i aften.
We have an appointment with destiny.
Vi har en aftale med fremtiden.
Fill the room. Fill the room.
We're waiting for you. We're waiting for you. We're waiting for you.
Wind of God, blow.
Fyld ham.
Wind of God, blow in this house.
Herrens visdom, come.
Holy Spirit. Fill the room. Fill
like a rushing water.
Flow like a rushing water. Blow like a rushing wind.
Holy Spirit.
Burn like a roaring fire.
Come fill our hearts
again.
Once again.
Blow like a rushing water.
One more time.
Again.
Fill us.
Again.
Fill us.
Burn like a rushing
fire. In the name of Jesus.
Come fill.
In the name of Jesus. Fill us.
Like
yes, Lord, fill us overflowing. Fill in the name of Jesus.
Like
never the same, never the
come
same, never the same. Never the same in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Overflowing, filled in the name of Jesus. Holy, holy. fill us.
Come fill us.
Fill us overflowing.
Because we are ready.
Oh, in the name of Jesus. We're ready. We're ready.
We wait.
We're ready. We're ready. We're ready. We're ready.
We're ready for.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. We're ready. We're ready. We're ready. We're ready. Never the same. Never the same. Never the same. In the name of Jesus.
We wait for.
Never the same. Never the same. Never the same. Never the same. In the name of Jesus. Fill, 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 fill. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Fill, 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 fill. In the name of Jesus. Yes. Yes. Same, never the same, never the same. Fail, 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 fail in the name of Jesus. Fail, 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 fail in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come in the name of Jesus. Thank you for filling us over and over and over again. Fill us up in the name of Jesus.
We're holy, holy. We waiting for you.
Yes, Lord, we're waiting.
We waiting for you.
Hallelujah.
Feel the room, we waiting for you.
You have an appointment with destiny.
Du har et aftale med fremtiden nu her.
You have an appointment with destiny tonight.
Du har en aftale i aften med fremtiden.
All week long, even in the preparing for this trip.
Yeah, selv op til forberedelsen til denne tur.
I had such a sense of destiny upon these meetings.
Så havde jeg ligesom der var en sense af fremtidsumbaring.
That the hand of God was upon us.
At Guds hånd var på os.
Not just for your own personal blessing.
Ikke bare for jeres egen personlige velsignelse.
And that's wonderful.
Men det er vidunderligt.
We need that.
Det har vi brug for.
We need that.
Det har vi brug for.
Hallelujah. We need the touch. We need fresh fire.
Vi har brug for frisk ild.
But other people are waiting.
Men der er andre der venter.
Nations are waiting.
Der er nogen der venter.
For that deposit.
For at det bliver lagt ind i.
That God is placing on the inside of you.
Det som Gud han giver dig.
There's a word.
Der er et ord.
There's a word of deliverance for nations.
Der er et ord af frihed til nationer.
There's a song of deliverance.
Og der er en sang af frihed.
David sang about it.
David han sang om det.
He said, "You always surround me."
Han siger, du var altid
with songs of deliverance.
Sang af frihed.
And people are waiting on the other side of our obedience.
Og der er nogen der venter på den anden side af vores lydighed.
This is a night of destiny.
Det her det er sådan en aften.
Can you imagine the Lord's disciples for 10 days?
Kan I forestille jer disciplene 10 dage?
Waiting for the Holy Spirit.
Som ventede på den hellige ånd.
How many of us would have given up?
Hvor mange af os ville have givet op?
This is taking too much time.
Det her, det tager for lang tid.
I have other things I can be doing.
Jeg har andre ting som jeg kan gøre.
I can be more productive doing something else.
Jeg kan være mere produktiv andre steder.
But for 10 days they waited.
Men de ventede 10 dage.
And I tell you it was worth it.
Og det var det værd.
It was worth the wait.
Det var det værd.
Maybe you've been waiting for weeks or months.
Måske har du ventet uger eller måneder.
For a fresh touch from God.
En frisk berøring af Gud.
I'm telling you it's worth the wait.
Det er ventetiden værd.
Because he is with us tonight.
For han er med os i aften.
He is walking among us tonight.
Han går imellem os i aften.
Like the scripture says in the book of Revelation.
Ligesom i Åbenbaringsbogen.
That he walks among the golden candlesticks.
At han vandrer imellem lysene.
He's relighting a fire.
Amen. Og det er ny ild.
He's lighting a fire on
Han
the inside of us.
Han tænder ild ind i os.
That we can burn.
Så vi kan brænde.
That we can burn.
Så vi kan brænde.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Tak, Helligånd.
We're waiting for you. We're ready for you.
Fill the room, fill the room. We're waiting for you.
We're waiting for you.
Vi har brug for det.
Is it just a song? Do you really mean what you're saying? What you're
Er det bare en sang, eller mener du det du synger?
It's my expectation.
Det er min forventning.
That you are filling this room.
At du fylder det her rum op.
That you're filling me.
At du fylder mig.
In these moments.
Og dem der er her. Der var en anden profet.
His name was Zechariah.
Hans navn var Zacharias.
In chapter 4.
Og i kapitel 4.
He woke up from a vision.
Så vågnede han op fra en vision.
And the question is, what do you see?
Og spørgsmålet var, hvad ser du? Hvad fornemmer du lige nu?
As a question, I'm asking you.
Det er et spørgsmål, jeg stiller dig.
But the prophet heard the question.
Og som profeten hørte spørgsmålet.
He said, I see two men as trees.
Så sagde han, jeg ser to mænd som træer.
And the Bible says that these are two anointed ones.
Og Bibelen siger, det er to salvede.
Who stand before the Lord.
Som står foran Herren.
Now these are not the two witnesses from the book of Revelation.
Det er det ikke de to vidner fra Åbenbaringsbogen.
These two men that Zechariah saw in his dream.
De er to mænd som Zacharias så i sin drøm.
They were physical men.
Det var fysiske personer.
One's name was Joshua.
En var Josua.
The other his name was Zerubbabel.
Og den anden var Zerubbabel.
One was a governor.
En var en guvernør.
He says, I see these two men as trees.
Og han sagde, jeg ser de her to som træer.
Two anointed men.
To salvede mænd.
One version says, two sons of oil.
Og en version siger, at det er, kom igen.
Two sons of oil.
Og to oliesønner, ja. To oliesønner.
Dos hijos de los siete. Amen. Dos hijos de los siete. Oil. Right? Two sons of oil.
To oliesønner.
He says, they're trees.
Og han sagde, de er træer.
They're olive trees.
De er oliventræer.
And I see the olives from the trees being crushed.
Og jeg ser, at de her oliven på træerne, de bliver knust.
And in the middle of those two trees, there's a golden lampstand.
Og imellem dem her, så er der en gylden olie, ja, olielysstage, olie.
That is collecting the oil.
Og den her olielysstage, den samler olien.
I don't know who this is for tonight, but I came with a word from the Lord for
jeg
you.
Jeg ved ikke hvem det er der til i aften, men jeg kommer med et ord fra Herren.
God is going to give you a purpose for your pain.
Gud, han kommer til at give en mening med din sorg, din smerte. Formål.
There is purpose in your pain.
Der er formål med det.
There's purpose in your struggle.
Der er formål med din kamp.
There's purpose in your crushing.
Og der er formål med din smerte, du går igennem.
The Bible says about Jesus.
Bibelen siger om Jesus.
That he was in the garden of Gethsemane.
At han var i Gethsemane have.
And that word means the place of crushing.
Og det betyder sted hvor man blev knust.
And there he sweat like drops of blood.
Og der svedte han ligesom dråber af blod.
But we know that God made sense out of his pain and his suffering.
Men vi ved at Gud han gav mening til det han gik igennem.
That suffering was for you.
Og den lidelse det var for dig.
It was for me.
Det var for mig.
And it's why we call him the Christ.
Og det er derfor vi kalder ham Kristus.
The anointed one.
Den salvede.
Because he was crushed.
Han blev knust.
For us.
For os.
There's purpose in your pain.
Der er et formål med den smerte du går igennem.
And we see this in this vision that the prophet had.
Og vi ser det i den her vision som profeten havde.
Said these are two trees.
Det er to træer.
And the crushing of the olives.
Og at oliven, de blev knust.
Are feeding oil to this central lamp.
Og det giver olie til den her lampe.
We know who the lamp is.
Vi ved hvem lampen er.
It's Jesus.
Jesus.
God takes our pain.
Gud tager vores smerte.
Our times of difficulty.
Og vanskelige tider.
Our struggles.
Vores kampe.
Our broken relationships.
Brudte relationer.
If we don't let it lead to bitterness.
Hvis vi ikke lader det lede os til bitterhed.
Something very precious is produced out of us.
Så vil der blive produceret noget værdifuldt i os.
First of all, the Bible says that God is near the brokenhearted.
Bibelen siger at Gud, han er nær de brudte hjerter.
He is with you right now.
Han er med dig lige nu.
Whatever pain you're experiencing.
Hvad en smerte du har.
But I want you to know.
Jeg vil have, at du skal vide.
God is doing something very precious in you.
Han er ved at gøre noget meget værdifuldt i dig.
I'm not saying that God is the author of your pain.
Jeg siger ikke, at han er den, der står bag din smerte. Han er forfatteren til den.
I'm just saying that if you stay focused on Jesus.
Men jeg siger, at hvis du forbliver fokuseret på Jesus.
God would use that pain.
Så vil Gud bruge den smerte.
To produce something very precious.
Til at producere noget meget værdifuldt.
It's called anointing.
Det er kaldet salvelse.
It's called oil.
Olie.
And you will be like one of those olive trees.
Og du kommer til at være som et oliventræ.
That oil is flowing to a central place.
Hvor den her olie, den flyder hen til et centralt sted.
You are little anointed ones.
I er de små salvede.
He's producing something very precious in us.
Han er ved at producere noget meget værdifuldt i os lige nu.
And you can stand before the Lord just like those two men.
Og du kan stå foran Herren ligesom de to mænd.
Even in your pain.
Selv i din smerte.
Tomorrow in our workshop.
I morgen når vi har vores workshop.
Linda and I are going to talk about how to navigate through difficult relationships.
Så vil Linda og jeg vil snakke om hvordan man navigerer i vanskelige forhold.
We have some stories to tell you about our children.
Vi har nogle historier vi kan fortælle om vores børn.
Very difficult things that we have gone through.
Meget vanskelige ting som vi har været igennem.
It had crushed our hearts.
Og det brudte vores hjerter.
But you know what people say about Bill and Linda?
Ved I hvad folk de siger om Bill og Linda?
What's so fresh about you?
Hvad er det ved jer?
And I say, if you have 2 or 3 hours, I'll tell you a story.
Og jeg sagde, hvis du har 2-3 timer, så kan jeg fortælle en historie.
There have been times of crushing.
Der har været tider, hvor vi var knust.
There have been times of suffering.
Lidelser.
You know, the Church of China is praying for persecution.
Ved I, at kirken i Kina, de beder imod forfølgelse.
To come to the
forfølgelse.
To come to the rest of the Christians of the world.
for at komme til resten af de kristne i
verden.
They're
praying for persecution.
De beder for forfølgelse.
Because of their persecution.
På grund af deres forfølgelse.
Has made the underground church in China.
Har skabt den her undergrundskirke i Kina.
To grow more than 80 million people.
Til at vokse sig til mere end 80 millioner.
Because of crushing.
På grund af de her tider, af knuste tider.
They're some of the most dedicated believers.
Det er nogle af de mest dedikerede troende.
I'm just saying that God can use that.
Jeg siger bare, at Gud han kan bruge det her.
And God is using Linda and I to add new levels.
Og Gud han bruger Linda og mig til at nå nye niveauer.
Because of the difficulties that we've been through.
På baggrund af de vanskeligheder vi har været igennem.
It's more than a story.
Det er mere end bare en historie.
It's anointing that is produced.
Det er en salvelse som bliver produceret.
From the crushing.
Igennem det brudte.
We have more compassion for people.
Vi har medlidenhed med mennesker.
Than we have ever had.
Mere end vi nogensinde har haft.
We have more understanding.
Og vi har mere forståelse.
We have more patience with people.
Og mere tålmodighed.
Where did that come from?
Hvor kom alt det fra?
God made purpose of our pain.
Gud han har et formål med den smerte vi går igennem.
He made a ministry out of our pain.
Han skabte en tjeneste ud af vores smerte.
Now we counsel with pastors whose marriages are broken.
Nu rådgiver vi pastorer, hvis ægteskaber er brudte.
And we can cry with them.
Vi kan græde med dem.
And we can see God heal them and restore them.
Og vi kan se Gud han helbrede og restaurere dem.
God has the same plan for you.
Gud han har den samme plan for dig.
He's going to turn your pain into a ministry.
Han vil forvandle din smerte til en tjeneste.
He's going to give you purpose for your pain.
Han vil give dig et formål med din smerte.
All of us are trees of righteousness.
Alle ind her er retfærdighedstræer.
Planted by the Lord.
Som er blevet plantet af Herren.
That he might be glorified.
Så at han kan blive løftet op.
Let Jesus be glorified.
Lad ham bare få alt ære, lad ham blive løftet op.
Come on, let Jesus be glorified.
Lad ham blive herliggjort.
In your life.
I dit liv.
And through your life.
Igennem dit liv.
Let Jesus be glorified.
Lad ham blive herliggjort.
Let Jesus be honored.
Lad ham blive æret.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Tak, Helligånd.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Come on, lift your hands one more time.
Løft dine hænder igen.
You don't have to be shouting.
Du behøver ikke at råbe.
Just receive.
Bare modtag lige nu.
Put yourself in a position to receive.
Bare sæt dig selv i en stilling, hvor du kan modtage.
This is not the moment to speak in tongues.
Det er ikke et øjeblik, hvor vi skal tale tunger.
You don't even have to pray.
Du behøver ikke engang at bede.
Just be quiet.
Bare vær stille.
And receive.
Og modtag.
Receive from the hand of the Lord.
Modtag fra Herrens hånd.
No one needs to touch you.
Ingen har brug for at røre ved dig.
This is a ministry of the Holy Spirit.
Det er det Helligåndens tjeneste.
And he's making a deposit on the inside of you.
Og nu lægger han noget ind i dig.
And when you go home tonight,
og når du går hjem i aften,
I want you to write on your calendar,
så skriv på din kalender.
Tonight I was touched by the hand of God.
I aften så blev jeg berørt af Guds hånd.
And you begin to notice from this day forward.
Og du vil vide fra i dag af.
The transformation.
Den transformation.
The work of God in your life. Thank you, Holy
Guds
Spirit.
Arbejde i dig.
We receive.
Vi modtager.
We receive.
Vi modtager.
We receive Holy Spirit.
Vi modtager Helligånd.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Tak, Helligånd.
Linda's going to come and pray for you.
Thank you, Father. If you'll put your hand over your heart, your spirit.
Hvis du bare kan placere din hånd på dit hjerte.
Where the pain has been, where you've been suffering, where you're hurting, where things are confusing.
Hvor smerten har været over de ting, som har været forvirrende.
Where you've not understood why this is going on in your life.
De ting, hvor du bare tænkte, du ved ikke hvorfor det er sket.
We just say, Father.
Vi siger far.
We give it to you now.
Vi giver det til dig lige nu.
All this pain.
Al den her smerte.
All this pain that I'm experiencing.
Al smerten jeg går igennem.
All the things I don't understand.
Alt hvad jeg ikke forstår.
I give it to you, Holy Spirit.
Jeg giver det til dig, Helligånd.
I give it to you to take all the tears, all the pain.
Og jeg giver det til dig, så du kan tage smerten og tårne væk.
All the words that try to crush me.
Alt det der prøver på at bryde mig.
All the people that have said things against me.
Mennesker der har sagt noget imod mig.
In my own family.
I min egen familie.
Father, we just give that pain to you now.
Vi giver dig den smerte nu.
We release it to you, Holy Spirit.
Vi giver den over til dig, Helligånd.
To take it to the heavenlies now.
Og for at tage det til det himmelske.
To do with it whatever you want to do.
Og gør med det som du ønsker.
And Father, we receive the healing.
Og vi modtager helbredelsen.
We take your healing.
Vi tager din helbredelse.
Father, we take your healing.
Vi tager din helbredelse.
To come deep into our hearts.
Til at komme dybt i vores hjerter.
To come deep into our spirit.
Dybt i vores ånd.
Father, to change our minds.
Til at ændre vores sind.
To renew the mind.
Forny vores sind.
To be able to see through your eyes.
Så vi kan se gennem dine øjne.
Not through our own pain.
Ikke gennem vores egen smerte.
But to see through your spirit.
Men at se gennem din ånd.
To see through your healing.
Og se gennem din helbredelse.
Through your passion.
Din passion.
For your love for the others.
For din kærlighed for de andre.
Because you love me, Father.
Fordi du elsker mig.
You love me so much that you take the pain.
Du elsker mig så meget at du tager smerten.
And turn it around for your glory.
Og du vender den for din herlighed.
You turn all things around for your glory.
Du vender alt for din herlighed.
For me to be able to stand.
Så jeg kan stå.
To stand in your truth.
Stå i din sandhed.
To stand in your confidence.
I din tillid,
to trofasthed. To stand in your strength.
Og til, kom igen.
Strength.
Og hvad er din styrke?
To stand in your understanding.
Og stå i din forståelse.
Father, we receive right now.
Vi modtager.
We receive your Holy Spirit.
Vi modtager din Helligånd.
We receive it to where we're in, so entrenched in the Word of God.
Og vi modtager det, så vi kan være så dybt i Guds ord.
We're so deep into the water.
Vi er så dybt ude i floden.
We're so deep into the fire.
Vi er så dybt ind i ilden.
That we're not harmed or bothered anymore.
At vi ikke længere bliver fornærmet eller rystet af noget andet.
But that we can walk in your freedom.
Vi kan vandre i din frihed.
We can run into your presence.
Og vi kan løbe ind i dit nærvær.
And receive more healing.
Og modtage mere helbredelse.
And be a blessing to others as needed.
Og være en velsignelse for andre.
Father, we thank you.
Far, vi takker dig.
I want you to reach out with your hand.
Jeg ønsker du skal række ud med din hånd lige nu.
I want you to act. This is sort of a prophetic drama.
Det er profetisk handling vi gør nu.
Okay. To like you're going to reach for a page of a book.
Det er som når du skal lige tage fat i en side i en bog.
Tonight we turn the page.
Og i aften så vender vi siden.
Yeah. There's a new chapter is being written.
Et nyt kapitel bliver skrevet nu.
New chapters of your life are being written.
Et nyt kapitel i dit liv bliver skrevet.
And history will prove what God has done in this house.
Og historien vil bevidne hvad Gud han har gjort i aften.
But we're turning the page.
Vi vender siden.
Hallelujah. We're taking what God has given us.
Vi tager det Gud han har givet os.
And we're moving forward.
Og vi bevæger os fremad.
Hallelujah. And I remind you of the Lord's disciples.
Og jeg vil minde jer om Herrens disciple.
They turned the world upside down.
De vendte jorden
because of an encounter with the Holy Spirit.
På grund af et møde de havde med Helligånden.
What are you going to do with what you have received?
Hvad gør du med det du har modtaget?
Let's turn the world upside down.
Lad os forvandle den her verden.
Hello. Amen. We have a gospel to preach.
Vi har et budskab vi skal prædike.
See, people saved.
Se mennesker frelst.
Lives transformed by the power.
Og liv bliver forvandlet ved ham.
Hallelujah. We have cities to win for Jesus.
Vi har byer vi skal vinde for Gud.
Hallelujah. So I pray a blessing over you.
Så jeg taler velsignelse over jer.
In the name of Jesus, the Lord bless you.
I Jesu navn, der Herren velsigne jer.
Can you handle that?
Kan I gøre det?
May the Lord bless you.
Må han velsigne jer.
Can you receive that?
Kan du modtage det?
May the Lord bless you.
Må Herren velsigne dig.
May he keep you.
Og må han bevare
and
dig.
And cause his face to shine upon.
Og må hans ansigt lyse over dig.
Because the word of God says.
Guds ord siger.
That when the face of the king brightens.
Når kongens ansigt lysner op.
He extends his favor.
Så kommer hans favør ud på os.
May the Lord be gracious to you.
Og må han være god ved dig.
I declare shalom.
Fred.
Over your life.
Over dit liv.
Your marriage.
Ægteskab.
Your family.
Familien.
Your churches.
Kirke.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Literally.
Bogstaveligt talt.
God taking all of the fragmented pieces.
Må han tage alle de brudte stykker.
Making it whole again.
Og gøre det helt igen.
That's the picture of shalom.
Det er billedet på shalom.
So shalom to you.
Shalom til dig.
In the name of Jesus.
I Jesu navn.
Shalom to you.
Shalom til dig.
For the glory of God.
For Guds herlighed.
We will never be the same.
Vi vil aldrig blive de samme igen.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Brother Kim. We will never
Vi vil aldrig blive de samme igen.
Hallelujah. As you're coming, I mentioned earlier that there was a tremendous sense of destiny.
Jeg fortalte, der har været en virkelig følelse af skæbne eller en fremtid her.
And there's an anointing for multiplication.
Der er en salvelse for multiplikation her.
Amen.
Amen.
There's an anointing for multiplication on this.
Der er en salvelse af multiplikation her på det her sted.
And we're excited to be a very small part of that.
Og vi er så spændte på at være en del af det.
Amen. God bless you.